play each other right about now. So excited to see the opening draws and mulligans. It is Control Priest versus Combo Druid. And so some big things to entomb, but how do you mulligan here for each player?
For Zuiwo, it's pretty similar. I mean, basically anything you play against. Obviously, he's not going to be playing against anything aggro oriented, so he's going to want to get as many minions early on as possible to get the tempo. For the priest, you basically want to make sure that Druid doesn't run away with the game. As long as you can control the game, prevent your opponent from getting enough damage in to be able to combo kill you, then you should be fine. For the Druid, you want to do the exact opposite. Obviously, you want to get a nice fast start that the priest has trouble dealing with, and then from there you can get enough damage and basically just kill them to death. Kill him to death, as which is a good way to defeat your opponent. But yeah, this is a fairly even matchup, I would say. Nothing too crazy. As we see the flash heal in the hand of NoTomorrow, he actually has Light of the Naru in this deck as well. So that's kind of a interesting situation there. I guess we haven't seen two Light of the Narus and two flash heals, so maybe he runs one of each. That's regardless. This is kind of unusual here.
Yeah,
He's
I mean,
definitely.
for oh, go ahead. I was just gonna
Yeah,
say
I
the
was
flash heals are.
going to speculate a bit about the possibility of NoTomorrow running Reno there, but definitely reasonable for NoTomorrow to run the priest first. I think priest is the deck. He's not though. Actually, this is the most unfamiliar deck for him of the remaining three, so you just try it. If you gotta win, then you're lucky, and if you don't, you can still get some wins with your other two decks there.
I imagine NoTomorrow takes his practice seriously, so he's probably pretty accustomed to this deck at this point. I think maybe the bigger reason is that two of the three options for him are good here. If he goes against the Zoo or the Paladin, the Secret Paladin of Zuiwo, he's in a favored matchup. This is the only one that's kind of even, and you could argue that's maybe slightly priest favored as well. So that's basically, I think, why he went for it. There's no real bad matchup, or that could be the case if he went for something else. But Zuiwo was pretty patient here. Didn't use his Innervate early on. Didn't want to mess up his curve at all. And now he's going to get a bit rewarded by being able to play this Druid of the Claw out, and then the Pilot Shredder the next turn, and still nothing to do here for NoTomorrow.
Yeah, no
Not
tomorrow. Well, go ahead.
You go ahead.
I was just gonna say that for no tomorrow, he's playing a control deck. So theoretically, no matter how bad the situation on the board gets, there will always be a way to clear it out. Now, Light Bomb and Circle of Healing, neither one of those are currently able to totally clear the board. They leave two things behind. So this is actually a pretty difficult board for NoTomorrow to deal with.
Right, and he doesn't actually have Light Bomb in the hand that would be in Tomb. I'm not sure if
No, I
you.
was just saying, like, as far
Right.
as options go,
Right,
ways
right, right.
that
Well,
Control Priest
if he
like
picks
to
up
go.
Arcanine Circle, then that would be able to clear up the board. So Circle in that instance would be useful if you are looking at potential top decks there. Direwolf
Right.
comes out of this and looks like he's able to just clear this out pretty reasonably and play out that Darnassus to put more pressure onto the board. Zuiwo looks like he didn't want to, like you mentioned, play or didn't want to risk his board against something like Light Bomb. So, definitely interesting play by him there. And gonna see the Cabal onto this Direwolf Alpha, just take that away from his opponent. Later in the sometimes you can take the Darnassus too, even though you do lose mana. It's kind of nice to just get a minion under the board. But definitely, if you're choosing between not losing mana and losing mana, I think you just go for the Direwolf Alpha here.
I mean, Direwolf Alpha represents not only damage in and of itself, but also damage for everything else that comes down onto the board, especially if you like get to cascade things into it, so that it keeps buffing things up. So definitely probably better to take that one away. You give yourself a little bit of extra damage, but I mean, even still, like, where do you progress from here? There is board clear available, depending on exactly what happens there and going to go ahead and coin out the swipe just to make sure that everything dies.
Swipe to the face. I love it. And down to 10 health goes NoTomorrow. And this is kind of nice, right? You want to win this game quicker rather than, you know, slower if you are the druid player. And putting, you know, a clock on the priest saying, you need to deal with my stuff now or you're dead is, I can get behind that play.
I could get behind it too. It's like putting on enough pressure so that you also, you know, this thing is the best defense is a good offense. So when you put up a good offense, that puts on the pressure, which then kind of functions as your defense. I mean, if you're going up against an opponent that wants to just sort of roll the dice and go for it, then that's certainly their prerogative, but it certainly can get a little bit you know, out of hand.
Right, exactly like you say. I mean, sometimes you know, you don't want to. You're a bit afraid of, you know, opponent getting good trades or whatever. But a lot of times, what people don't realize is that if you hit the face, they have to overreact, and sometimes that gives you card advantage in the long run, which is kind of a weird indirect relationship, right? You don't think that, you know, you think that, okay, I'm gonna get good trades on the board. That's how I'm gonna get card advantage. If you're thinking of that route, obviously, if you're just trying to kill them, that's a different story. But sometimes you can actually gain card advantage by hitting the face because it makes your opponent overreact.
And yeah, that's the other thing about overreaction is that you definitely have to maintain your nerves throughout an entire day of Hearthstone. It's 5 best of 5s. That is a lot of Hearthstone to have going on in one day. So definitely have to keep your stamina up and make sure that you can, in fact, you know, go toe-to-toe, just mentally, versus your opponents.
Right, and we see the Pyromancer pickup here from NoTomorrow. Really can't do too much here. He can actually kill out this Thorson right now with that pickup on the Arcanine Soul Priest. However, that does prevent him from... I mean, he can Arcanine Circle. He might actually save the Flash Shield for his face. This is kind of an awkward situation, right? Because he used the Arcanine Flash Shield to kill out the Thorson. He doesn't kill off his own creature, but he's a bit more susceptible to dying to some sort of burst from Zuiwo. So everything here is just kind of a tough decision. And I think he... I mean, I was going to say, I think he just goes for the Flash Shield to kill it out, but now you have two circles in your hand. They're pretty dead. So, yeah, what do you do here? I mean, you've seen two swipes, and you've seen a Wrath as well. So it's actually kind of difficult to deal with both of these minions. Yeah, it's still kind of, you know, a tough situation for NoTomorrow.
Well, for NoTomorrow, I mean, at least he does have the board advantage for now, but possibly not for long, considering look at all of the cost-effective cards that have all been discounted. I don't know how much scarier a turn 6 Dr. Boom is than a turn 7 Dr. Boom, but this is extremely difficult to deal with.
Right, we'll see if maybe... I imagine you just go for the... Dr. Boom plus the Shade, because you're not really worried about Holy Nova, because Holy Nova hurts your opponent as well, and it actually just kills off his own Pyromancer, and Circle kills off your opponent's board as well. So I don't really see the downside in going for that. I suppose he could throw away his Arcanine in that situation, but then he throws away his Arcanine, which is, you know, fine as well. Yeah, and this puts a really... This makes it really awkward, again, for NoTomorrow. He picks up a Light Bomb, which can clear the board, but again, he's clearing his own minions almost certainly.
Yeah, I was going to say that Zuiwo might have flashback about the Mind Control deck, about playing the fourth minion
there. Oh, right. Yeah, but Priests, I mean, they have their own ways of removal. You can't really fit a Mind Control deck in there. But yeah, just going to be hitting or using that circle rather than the Light Bomb. Going to put up this Justicar so he can get extra healing going forward. And can NoTomorrow possibly stabilize here?
A little bit difficult after Zuiwo draws this Drift Claw, because you now can get board carry. He's not...
Oh, okay. I guess he's just trying to establish every single minion that can't charge, and then perhaps he can, you know, finish off his opponent on the following turn. Looks like it's probably going to be a Light Bomb. Actually, it kills it. Light Bomb actually just kills that minion. Because yeah, he's checking it now. He's checking the text. It when the light bomb goes off, it turns into a 3-3 and then dies. So he can actually kill it off with light bomb, which is it's kind of sad, right? Usually you play the spell and it works out, but
Sorry to cut you up there. Actually, NoTomorrow actually went to a Chinese Hearthstone quiz show about all the crazy Hearthstone mechanics. So he might have the flashback about participating at quiz shows, saying, "Oh, how does this work here?"
I mean,
what didn't I learn about this kind of interaction on that show?
Right, so he does it. He's able to clear the board, and Zuiwo doesn't have lethal. But he is able to now finally, you know, cycle this wild growth. Is going to go with the Azure Drake first, though, because at least he gets something onto the board. And I mean, do you just Druid the Claw charge into this Northshire Cleric? You've already seen one Aconite Circle. You've already seen one Light Bomb. It's unlikely for your opponent to be able to kill your board at this point, and you're denying card draw, which is very important at this stage of the game.
Yeah, I think you do, and you don't want to see anything like a Valence Chosen as well, so...
Right, exactly. So yeah, gonna go ahead and clear that off. I do like this play. And there's the Aconite Circle.
The caster curse is real.
Wow. I mean, you've seen the Aconite Circle. Oh, there's the other one. Okay, there you go. And he's at 16 health now, is NoTomorrow. And getting, you know, even higher up there. I mean, unfortunately for his case, I mean, Zuiwo is going to draw three cards here, essentially, and be able to hero power him down. I imagine you don't play the Raven Idol now because you want to use your hero power and you want to cycle as well to see what you have before you play the Raven Idol. But it looks like he's hovering over it.
I think you're
going to get a 5-5 anyway. I think you want to see what you have before you play Raven Idol.
I'm always a big fan of seeing what happens first, because I mean, maybe sometimes if you see what happens, you lose the opportunity to do something else, but then at least you gain the opportunity to have something good happen for you. So I'm, I don't know. This is a highly
goes for a minion. Can potentially go for. I think you just go for Chromagus, right? Yeah, this is really nice because this might be able to bait out Shadowward Death. You don't know what that card is in your opponent's hand. It's very likely not going to be Shadowward Death, and if you can bait it out and then play the Chromagus. Not to mention the fact that you just picked up combo, so if there isn't a Shadowward Death, you just win the game.
Yeah, I mean, Chromagus, actually, you can have the combo, you can play Chromagus, and you can play the Circle, so, that saves him.
It saves him. He's going to go up to 20 health, but he's going to need another answer right away for this Chromagus. I imagine it's going to be Wild Growth into Chromagus. Unless he picks up something like, you know, Roar and then picks up an Innervate off of this. Actually, he wouldn't be able to play Innervate after this Wild Growth, huh? So, he does pick up the second Roar. I mean, I don't really see the point of Hero Powering, so, okay, it's going to trigger me and play the and draw cards afterward. You always want to draw cards last, guys. You never know when the card you could have could have been useful. No, that's obviously a joke. That's obviously a joke. You want to? Oh, he actually. I'm an idiot. Okay, sorry. I just made an idiot of myself. Obviously, you play the Chromagus first because you get the card off of it. Sapcasters, I encourage you to say that in the chat right now. But so Zuri was absolutely correct there. I'm forgetting the interaction with Chromagus. But gonna go up to 24 health. Is NoTomorrow, and he is not dead because there's only 22 damage on the field. But double Sylvanas is pretty devastating here, and I imagine you just play the Sylvanas. Maybe you silence out the Cairn, you hit the face, and then you're in really good shape here.
I think you actually kill the 1-2 with your Keep the Grill because you can get the Bane with the second Keep the Grill.
Right. So yeah, he's gonna just go with that, and he's already seen 1 and 2. So yeah, definitely this Sylvanas kind of nullifies this Cairn here. Can't really trade into anything, so just gonna kill off that Museum Curator, hit the face, and now I think we're finally going to see NoTomorrow die here after valiantly holding off his opponent for a long, long time.
Well, all I have to do is watch this mind control. Oh, not mind control tech. Mind control tech has a chance to steal something. This one is guaranteed, and so we're gonna cabal our way to victory here and make sure to keep as much on No Tomorrow's side as possible. I guess the downside to that is that turns out if you leave stuff on the board versus combo druid, you actually just die. And there's the surrender coming out. No Tomorrow realizes. So wait. I left stuff on the board versus Druid. I just died.
Yeah, exactly. And it's especially, you know, draining when you see the same cards not being used out of your opponent the entire time. They're just playing off the right side of their hand, and you're just like, well, that's absolutely combo there. It's 100%. There's no denying it. And you leave a couple minions on the board, and you're dead. That is the problem with sometimes playing against Druid. But that is going to be Druid cleared here for Zuiwo. And that means that he has two decks remaining. That is going to be the Zulok and the Secret Paladin. And for No Tomorrow's sake, I mean, he has decent decks to go against that. His own Druid is pretty weak, but other than that, his Priest can deal with it. And depending on his Warlock is, he can deal with that as well. I guess the biggest issue here is that his Druid, since this is Conquest, his Druid could be his downfall in this remaining two games.
Yeah, that's true. And we haven't seen the No Tomorrow's Warlock as well, so that could be a possibility of weak point against one of the classes from Zuiwo there. But going with the Priest first is definitely the correct call. Doing really well against both the classes that Zuiwo has left.
Right, one consideration here, at least going back to last game, I mean, it did definitely made sense for No Tomorrow, at least on one line of logic, to go with the Priest. But if you think that your Druid is very vulnerable to the remaining two classes, maybe you make sure that your Druid gets a win first before you send it out there, before you send your Priest out there to potentially take out the one deck that your Druid can beat. But, yeah, in any case, we are getting into this game. Going to be the Zulok versus the Control Priest, and No Tomorrow, he's looking very sad right now. He just played out his North Shark Cleric into a Flame Imp and has nothing really to be able to get accomplished here.
Well, I mean, as far as starts go, I mean, both players got pretty much the best one they could ask for. I mean, to be fair,
unfortunately, the best one for Zuiwo.
Yeah, I was just saying, it's like, I got the perfect one drop. Oh, wait. My opponent got an even more perfect one drop, and we're even healing it.
Yeah, Zuiwo with a bit of flair there, saying thank you over to No Tomorrow. It's like, thanks for the free kill here. And he gets to play out whatever he wants. Can go for the Inking boss, can go for the Dark Peddler. The world is his oyster. At least the Hearthstone board is his oyster.
But, and the Hearthstone board is like a little tiny world in and of itself. And of course, you've also got that hole by the pot that just takes infinite money inside. Like, I'm sure that's another world that's also his oyster because it's, you know, on his side.
I mean, little tiny board, you know, little tiny pearls are nice and cute. But I'm going to go ahead and play out this Imking boss instead. Definitely makes sense if you think about it because in future turns, he wants to play out his Abusive Sergeant for a good effect. And this gets the most damage on the field, the most annoying stuff on the field. This in-game boss could get stolen by a Cabal Child Priest in the future, so he wants this in-game boss on the field right now to be able to get some work done before it potentially gets stolen.
That's definitely it. And it's good, like, really good against some paramental shenanigans that possibly coming from No Tomorrow, and very disappointed No Tomorrow just tried to heal up his opponent's aim combos, but it doesn't actually need any here.
Yeah, it's already nice and full. Alright, so going to be the Dark Peddler coming out from Zuiwo. He is going to be facing up against an Arcanized Circle next turn, so let's see if he tries to play around that. All of those options are kind of reasonable. The Reliquary Seeker is the only actual minion, so maybe he go for that. Maybe he finds himself with a 5-5, which is pretty difficult for, you know, Priest to deal with if there's another entire board to deal with. The Mortal Coil is also nice as well. The Corruption could be pretty good if you find your opponent, you know, uses Valence Chosen on something. So this is actually a pretty tough choice here for Zuiwo. Looks like he does go for the Relic Query Seeker, and he's actually going to use his Abusive Sergeant as well, and I imagine this board is big enough for for NoTomorrow to go for the Aconite Circle here, even if his Aconite immediately dies afterward. Yeah, going to go for it.
Right, and I mean, to be fair, everything on the board does get cleared, except for that Imp, and of course, the last remaining shred of health there from the Aconite Soul Priest, so... a little bit rough for, I guess, kind of both players. I feel like as the game draws on later and later, it becomes better for NoTomorrow, just because he has the Entomb in hand and the ability to turn his opponent's cards against themselves.
Right. The biggest thing here is that NoTomorrow's at 23 health, right? He doesn't have to really worry about dying anytime soon, and that's very important. And he has options for big guys and little guys here. Which is also really annoying if you're the opponent, right? I mean, Priest used to be like, they had very situational answers. Now Priest has all the answers. When you're playing an aggressive deck, you're like, come on, can you just stop for 1 second killing my stuff? Can be very vexing.
It certainly can be. I mean, vexing is a great word there. So speaking of things that are very vexing, those runts are also super annoying too. Because then when they come out on the field, they're just like, hey... I don't know if you guys heard the summoning.
Name? Is it Wombling Runs? I forgot.
I think it is.
It's like, what is it? Wombling? Wombling's not a word, is it?
No, it definitely isn't.
Rumbling. It's not Rumbling Runs. I think it's a W, right?
It's Wobbling.
Wobbling, right. Why did I put an M in there? I'm crazy. anyway. But, yeah. Wobbling runts, and they're very wobbly, and when they die, they all topple over and become minions that you can use to attack.
Right. Well, I mean, that sounds like a good deal to me, man.
we never saw the runts. What they look like?
I seen what they look like. I don't know about you, Shrink. Runts, actually, if you attack with the 2/6. All three voices come out. They you know, the voice actors, each one says something when they attack. So there's actually three attack, like, shout-outs, whatever you call it, right? And then when they die, obviously, they each have their own. It's kind of cute.
Kind of. I mean, this is the struggle for Hearthstone, is, like, half the cards are just, like, actually extremely cute, and the other half are just, like murderous with bloody intent on their minds. And you're just like, oh, that's so sweet, but, oh, he's also killing me. And then, of course, like, the ones that are super scary are just like, oh, wow, I really expect that guy to kill everything. And then it's just like, you know, wants to hug and be friends, just like, wait a second. That's not the way things are supposed to work, but either way, as far as the board's concerned, back to, you know, what's going on here. A very, very big board, kind of overextending, maybe just a little bit, and definitely the opportunity to punish this board with Light Bomb.
Right, I think that's what Zuiwo was thinking about. He's like, okay, if this board gets Light Bomb, then I do get either another Void Caller or another Doomguard. It's really awkward situation for the Zoo, because you feel like you're so ahead and you're controlling the board, but you know that, you know, any misstep and your opponent can just wipe your board just so easily. So it's just kind of like, what can my opponent possibly do here? As for NoTomorrow, I think you just Shadow Madness the Void Caller and then just get rid of it that way. But looks like he doesn't agree with me. He's going to go with his play right here, getting rid of the board. And it does pop out the Doomguard, but he can entomb that later. And now action back over to Zuiwo, has that Void Caller again, but nothing in hand to really, you know, use it with.
Mm-hmm.
And not much to do here. I mean, obviously he can get 8 damage onto the face, which is kind of nice. I mean, I guess, do you just push damage to face here? You have to win the game at some point, and if you take too long, you give the priest more options.
And we definitely don't want to give Priest options. Like, that's kind of what their entire deck is made out of anyway. So giving them more is probably not a super great way to win the game. But I love this egg drop already here by Zuiwo, because it prevents the board from being able to be cleared quite as easily.
Right. That's going to prevent anything like, you know, Aconite Circle or, you know, Light Bomb. We've seen one of those each, but... Obviously, he's thinking about last game when the second Aconite Circle came out in that instance, but taking off 6 damage, or at least 5 damage off the board, is NoTomorrow here. But Dr. Boom coming to save the day here for Zuiwo. Let's see if he plays that on the board. Actually, he could play Dr. Boom and Reliquary Seeker, and he's already seen one Light Bomb, so that could be the play here. I think you just go for it, right? I mean, you get a 5-5, a 7-7, 2 Boom Bots, and gets 5 damage to the face. You've already seen a lot of AoE clear. I mean, looks good to me. If it's, I think it's now or never, honestly. I mean, you just you just hope that your opponent doesn't have the second Light Bomb, because if the longer you take to fill the board, the more likely he is going to have Light Bomb in the future.
Yeah, so you might be thinking about the placement, because he has now has a double Fire Alpha on the board. So you might be thinking about the placement where to put his Dr. Boom and where to put your Reliquary Seeker.
Really? He's not going to play it. Interesting. I think it's pretty easy, honestly. You put the Dr. Boom on the left, you put the Reliquary Seeker on the right. Mm-hmm. But not going to do so. Maybe he was looking for something to use with Void Color. Like, he really wanted... I think he just really wanted to get this Void Color, maybe too fixated on that. Maybe just kind of Tunnel Vision. But he's going to get some decent damage onto the field. Another Entomb comes in the hand, but no actual AoE here for NoTomorrow. There could be potentially, you know, something like Pyromancer into Shadow Madness, and then you could kill off the... Well, I guess you can't really kill off the Void Caller, and you don't really know what's coming out of that.
You could Arcanine kill the Death World Alpha.
Yeah, but then you have an Arcanine in the field, and your opponent can just you know, just ignore your Arcanine go face, which is a problem. This is kind of awkward for NoTomorrow. Not to mention that he would have been dead if Zuiwo just went for the Dr. Boom play. But it looks like he is going for the play that you mentioned, Shrink. Just going to kill off the Star Elf Alpha, take 4 damage off the board. And I think you have to play the Shrink Meister as well, just because, you know, you need things to combat the opponent's board, since you don't have any... you don't... Your clear is not AoE. But how many damage do we have? We have 4 on the field, plus 4 in hand. Probably gonna see a tap here, since we saw a tap last time. I can't really see anything else, especially because, I mean, you're okay with the Flame Imp coming out, but you want something better. Double, okay, that's gonna be it. That's gonna be second Power Whelming. That's going to be game. Zuiwo actually upsets for the second time in a row, and he's gonna go 2-0 in this series.
Yeah, and actually talking about Wombling,
I've got you saying Wombling too. Wombling runs. So
yeah, actually, NoTomorrow himself is famous for shaking his body while playing. I mean,
he likes to womble, is what you're saying.
Womble, yeah, pick himself.
Yeah, so NoTomorrow likes to be one of those wobbling runs there, but it is going to be Zuiwo's Secret Paladin, and one of the stronger decks, at least on ladder. Not always played in tournaments because it can get countered, but hard to see Secret Paladin losing 3 games in a row here. In particular, I mean, it really depends on what NoTomorrow's Warlock is, but if it is Zuiwo, then Zuiwo is in the commanding lead here.
Wow. I mean, to some extent, it's kind of... I feel bad saying it's all come down to this, because this is just the group stages, but if you don't make it out of the group stages, then you don't make it to what it really all comes down to in the playoffs. So
it comes down to this for NoTomorrow, right? I mean,
yeah.
And NoTomorrow, I mean, there's a lot of players here that are very skilled. I mean, there's a lot of players that you guys watching probably haven't heard of. But, I mean, NoTomorrow, he's definitely had a lot of results. He won the April Gold Series in Wuhan, and he got the BlizzCon. I mean, he double qualified for this, which is hard to do. I mean, people just want the single qualification, right? So, if NoTomorrow goes out here, I mean, he was in contention for winning this entire tournament, and that would be pretty crazy to see him go out first in this group. So, that's what he's facing right here.
I see NoTomorrow winning the whole thing anytime soon. I mean, after a while, I mean, as I said in the beginning, after a while, people got to know you, and you just got countered really hard. Also, NoTomorrow is kind of unlucky that his group is today. He's playing after yesterday having played the 2 best of 17 team matches. So,
and he also has the show match today as well, right?
I think so, but I think the horde needs somebody else.
Well, maybe NoTomorrow just is trying to get this day over with as quickly as possible and just lose twice and go over to the Hearthstone Team Story Studio to play that show match. No, obviously, I'm just kidding. Gold Series is a very important tournament, and you want to win as much as possible. Fortunately, he finds himself down double match point here, triple match point actually, if you consider the last match potentially. But yeah, he's gonna have to go through this paladin with all three of his decks, that obviously being the Control Priest, the Druid, and the Unknown Warlock, and definitely going to be an uphill battle for him. As we see Xing Su here looking on and commenting, he is in much better spirits after being almost dead after his matches yesterday. Obviously, was a bit of a struggle for him.
And he had some sleep, rather sound sleep, because I mean, after a day of Hearthstone, you know you are done for the year. Now you can prepare for the real festival season, and you can have really some good food. You can get family together. So I mean, that's kind of sort of blessing in
Well,
disguise,
I
but.
feel like you could enjoy the festival season more if you had $23,000 in your pocket or a golden Hearthstone trophy.
Yeah, that's definitely true. Yeah, that's what actually Valera could possibly do. Even I don't really see him winning the whole thing. Valera, I mean, he actually said about this. He said, "I'm more comfortable with casting because I'm very anxious about not seeing my opponent's cards when I'm playing."
Yeah, definitely nice to be in the commentator's seat and see all the cards and not have to have any doubt about what you're, going against. In any case, we're going to yet another favorite matchup for NoTomorrow here. Hopefully, for his sake, he can take this one out and make this a bit of a closer series. But it's going to be going against that secret paladin that we see Zuiwo has remaining. And we'll see how this goes. Notamar looks like he's kept double Pyromancer plus Light of Nauru. That's pretty interesting here.
I think he changed up these two words. Yeah, he actually changed two cards. And
Well, at least for his sake, I mean, you want at least one Pyromancer if you're going to be going as Paladin. Very good again, getting clearing those 1/1s off the board if your opponent does muster. So at least he has that going for him. And actually, he could play a Temple Pyromancer if he does feel like it, just so he has the second one in hand. But I guess having both of them in tow is pretty nice as well. So going to hold on to that, potentially use it next turn.
But this secret river is has possibility of getting out of range, and I got into duplicates in his hand, which is really funny.
Yeah, he has two pair, right? It's pretty good. So let's see if I mean, Zuiwo's two pair right now is beating the one pair of NoTomorrow, so he at least has that going for him. I imagine Zuiwo's gonna continue to hold on to his coin here because he can just play out. He can play out a couple secrets here. He can play out maybe one secret if he wants to, and then in the future he can just go on for Shredder on 4 and then coin into the A mysterious challenger on 5. Unfortunately, drawing into the repentance is a bit problematic for him because usually secret paladins only run one repentance, and if I remember the games from before, I think he only has one repentance as well. So looks like he wanted to go for the secret plus hero power here and just trade off into this injured blade master before it causes any problems against healed and all that stuff. But does get the repentance off instead of the noble sacrifice, which he looks like he deemed was the more likely thing to get, or to get value here. But not going to be the case because there is this powered shield here, and I imagine that NoTomorrow is probably going to play this Snorlax clearing the field. Nope, just gonna pass the turn once I get guaranteed cards in the future. Ooh, second Noble Sacrifice comes out for Zuiwo. With double Mysterious Challenger in hand, that is really painful to see.
It's just like how many turns can you play completely on curve and have your opponent, not just like, reach for that surrender button too quickly.
Going back to NoTomorrow's turn. I mean, there are some interesting things he can do with Circle here. I mean, he can even double pyro Circle, which would be a lot of cards. But looks like that's not going to be the case. He's actually going to, attack and just kill off this Paladin Shredder. Guess there's a ship's cannon. I don't believe there's any pirates in Paladin or a Secret Paladin. Occasionally, very, very occasionally, you see a Southsea deck cannon, but not going to be the case this turn. And NoTomorrow's just going to pass. I imagine, I mean, Zuiwo's been holding on to this coin the entire time, so I think he's just going to play
Right.
this Mysterious Challenger here.
Well, to be fair, it does give you a lot of options eventually in the end when you do wind up playing your big minions. You're going to have maybe a little bit more work to that you're able to do, which can be, like I said, very significant depending on how effective you want to use that. But that's not what we're going for here. It is just going to be an attempt to get out the earliest of Mysterious Challengers. And wow. Well, for Zuiwo, he's pretty good at playing Mysterious Challenger. Only gets three secrets off of it, though.
Yeah, I mean, we knew that coming in because of the Repentant and the double Noble Sacrifice in hand. Really unfortunate that he drew that. His second Mysterious Challenger will draw, I believe, two, which isn't too bad considering how many secrets he's drawn, but he's going to have to play out these Noble Sacrifices on themselves. As for NoTomorrow, he doesn't know what these secrets are. He just knows that his opponent either has Competitive Spirit in hand or he has two of one of the other secrets in hand. Because he's seen the games before if he was paying attention, so.
Well, actually, you are not allowed to see the games.
Oh.
I...
Well then. But he knows something is up here because three secrets is kind of bizarre. So gonna be taking this ship's cannon. He saw Repentance earlier. It's very unlikely that players run two Repentances unless you're, rank 14 on ladder. But gonna just be taking that out and has a Shadow Ward Death in hand for future turns. Nice patience from him. I mean, obviously, if he used Shadow Ward Death, it would have come back as a 6/1 and buffed up that ship's cannon most likely. So good patience here, not attacking and doing anything too rash.
And so now we get a chance to see whether or not the mini Dr. Boom, how effective that is. It's missing the boom bots, but it's still a pretty good one. And I think ideally you want to play Lotheb right here to protect it from getting deathed, right?
Yeah, that would be
Yeah, I
pretty
think.
nice. One thing I think Zuiwo is thinking about, I think he's not going to. Huh. That's interesting. I suppose what he's thinking about right here is that if he's gonna trade with the 4/5, I think he was gonna Lotheb if he went face, but since he traded with a 4/5, he's not too sad if that gets death right now. Is what he was thinking.
Like it's already fulfilled its purpose.
Right,
You
exactly.
can it's like in the end of Titanic, you're like, I'll never let go, Jack. And then Jack decides to attack face with the or to attack the minion with a 77 body. And you're like, all right, Jack, sorry, man. We gotta peace out. I gotta float myself on this rubbish, and you are weighing me down. So, not gonna hang on anymore to Jack the Mysterious Challenger. He is probably getting death this turn.
What do you think about going for the Pyromancer plus Holy Nova there rather than attacking first?
I was going to talk about it because I thought it was the play that NoTomorrow was going to, but you might be thinking like he's now going to wish us
Well,
an
if he
onset.
does go for that, then the first thing that dies. Wait, what did he attack into? I forgot. He attacked into a 2/2? I'm totally forgetting what happened.
Yeah, the first
The mini bot. Yeah, the mini bot was played
deal.
afterward. Yeah. So if he the first thing that was played was the Mysterious Challenger. So the Mysterious Challenger would come back as a 6/1, and then everything else would be cleared except for a 2-drop that comes from the field. So I guess that's reasonable. And he does draw his cards anyway, so it's kind of still okay.
Kind of. And he did go for the Pyromancer to add that one extra AoE damage down there too. So at this point he's probably most afraid of Dr. Boom, but also of course Mysterious Challenger is going to be pretty scary. And it's only a Mysterious Challenger that's going to give him what like two
Two.
secrets. Yeah.
Redemption, if he has a second one, and Avenge. It's guaranteed one with the Avenge. It's likely going to be two. And he can put three secrets on the board right now, which is reasonable. The big question for Zuiwo here is it's really hard to not hit the face for seven right now because it's really viable to start getting that damage in. But at the same time, this Pyromancer can be very problematic. So let's see what he goes for.
And it's just going to go ahead and
Oh,
get,
just one.
yeah, wow, two secrets, okay.
Yeah, one, and then he put the Noble Sacrifice on, so that's unfortunate. Flash Shield is kind of nice here for NoTomorrow. He can use it offensively or defensively, just healing himself back up.
He's also got Light of the Naru as well, so that's, if you get two Flash Heals and Light of the Naru, that's three mana, and you're dealing 13 damage to your opponent's face, so. Just saying, that could be pretty cool. Well, I guess it's seven mana because you have to play the Alcanai anyway.
Right, and even the, if you have the Justicar in hand or in play, that would be kind of nice. But let's see what he goes for here. There is a clear with just Alcanai Circle Ping. Well, yeah, there is a clear because you can just clear out this this guy first. Could be just a death as well, but looks like it is going to be the. Well, there's a lot of things he can do here, actually. He's going on the rope. There's actually so many ways he can clear this board. It's just figuring out which one is the worst, if that makes sense. The one that uses the least effective options in hand, because you want the best options for later if you're in trouble. If that makes sense.
And to be fair, I think that's about the best way that you could have solved the puzzle that was on the board is to just go ahead and use the Alcanai's, damage to turn your healing into something that can help you clear the board. Now, I guess putting that at 7 health is actually pretty interesting too,
Yeah,
because
and
if Tyrion's the play here, it will get +1 attack and then be able to just clear it perfectly.
right, but he can use death, which is kind of the reason why he didn't use death there. So
Right.
yeah, going back to what you were saying, he used the Flash Shield rather than the Circle. If you use the Circle, the Alcanai could be killed by Master for a battle. Now it's at 7 health. This Master Swordsmith's not going to do anything at all. And yeah, so I do like to play by NoTomorrow. The Flash Shield, that was probably it's a pretty reasonable use of it. You can use Circle later, even if you don't have Alcanai on the board, to maybe just heal all your minions up, which is kind of nice as well. And now he's in a pretty dominant position. It's really hard to see him losing from this spot.
Well, I mean, we've seen dominant positions, I think most notably yesterday, and I think maybe once the day before, but I can't really recall that. But most notably yesterday, like I was saying, dominant positions that all of a sudden turn into, well, not quite so dominant positions. I think we
Well,
have one at hand right here. I think you just circle and then heal.
yeah, a circle and heal, and I mean, NoTomorrow knows what this is, right? It has to be Noble Sacrifice because he's seen RE2 Avenged. I guess it could have been Redemption, which is why he did what he did, because the Master Swordsmith comes out, which is not such a big deal. But yeah, it's just going to be, the Alcanai going back down to 3-1, which is what we thought was going to happen in the first place. So this is what normally happens when you circle and goes on to 3-1, which is perfectly fine. Put the zombie child on the board, has a death, has a Justicar. I mean, this doctor move is nice, but I don't know. I just don't see a win here for Zuiwo.
Well, I think for Zuiwo, what he has to watch out for is, just not having any options anymore. And one way to take those options away is things like Entomb, things like consistent board clear, things like death, and basically the entire priest class. So I don't know. It's going to be difficult for him to find something that sticks to the board because either it gets deathed or it gets
Yeah.
Entombed, just like that. I actually think the
It's
better
kind
I
of.
have option is to save Entomb and use death
Well,
instead.
yeah, I mean, I think he would have saved the Entomb, particularly for the Tyrion, but he drew the second Entomb, so I think that's actually kind of fine. Because now he gets a Doctor Boom, which he can finish out the game later, and at this point, you've already dealt with all your opponent's stuff. Like, usually in Control Priest, you don't want threats, you just want answers, but now that he's dealt with everything, after this Tyrion, he's gonna have dealt with everything, so. I think it's fine just saying, okay, let me just pick up this Doctor Boom. Maybe I can draw it and I'll just finish the game out that way.
And this is why Entomb is so good. Like you don't even have to think about any of the other cards in your hand. You're just like, hey, I want that.
Gimme that card.
Pretty much. And it doesn't even put like a copy in your opponent's deck as well, so that they can get it back. It's just like gone from them. They just lost it. So that is
I would
it's
have.
kind of the.
What do you think about not using Light of Naru on your face first there? I would have really liked to have a 5-2 right here. I don't know. Anyway, Side Filter hits the board, and yeah, this is. I mean, Zuiwo, looking at the board states right now, it looks, okay for Zuiwo, I suppose, but there's four cards in NoTomorrow's hand in the first place, and then on top of that, his deck is way more dense. Zuiwo has nothing after this. He's played two Mysterious Challengers, a Tyrion, and a Boom, and they're all dead, and there's nothing left. There could maybe be a Rag, but there's even a death for that.
Hopefully you find a situation where you have, you know, like, too many threats for the death to be able to take care of, but ideally... That's not going to happen. And, of course, now that he's had both of his deathable threats entombed, it's like, well, what is there really to be afraid of?
Right. And, I mean, this is the kind of inevitability that you kind of expected from Priest versus Paladin. Unfortunately, it took NoTomorrow 3 games to get to this position. It looks like just pushing the face here for Zuiwo. NoTomorrow could actually just race him, honestly. I mean, there's no real burst in Paladin. I mean, let's see, there's 5, 6, 7, 8 on the board. There's nothing really he could draw. I suppose there could be a Divine Favor, crazy thing like that. But, okay, he's going to play it safe, just clear the board. You don't really need to race if you don't need to.
It's kind of bad to waste all of that on just, you know, just 1-1s, but...
I mean, that's kind of the thing, right? I mean, if you keep trying to clear the board, you can't actually heal yourself. If you didn't have the Arcanine on board on the field... then I'd be perfectly fine with clearing, but I kind of want to just hit the face here, just to make your opponent deal with you. Runs again. More wobbling.
Leaving
runs. I was going to start riding for a Major Domo, but not going to be the case. But yeah, going to be... Makes sense to go for the Justicar here. You kind of want to get that established already. And now he has Lethal on board. So there's nothing really for Zuiwo to do here. He has to start clearing the board, and yeah, he's just going to concede. That's going to be 1-4, NoTomorrow. Finally, his Priest is able to get a win here, but he's still down 1-2, and still has to take out the Secret Paladin with his Druid and his Warlock.
Yeah, both of which can run into troubles against Secret Paladin, but I don't know. What do you think about the deck choices that NoTomorrow has at his disposal? Specifically, you know, now that he's been... maybe struggling just a teeny tiny bit.
I mean, if you think about it, it's really complicated when you have a ban in your lineup, right? Because it's harder to kind of target certain things. The fact that he has Hunter and Priest, they're so different. I'm wondering what he was actually targeting, if he was targeting anything at all. Maybe it might have been just he wanted to go with a lot of decks that he thought were good in general. It obviously depends on what he brought here with the Warlock, which we might be seeing right now. But no, gonna go with the Druid. So his Warlock, it's gotta be Zu. It almost has to be Zu, because that's almost the one thing that's even worse against Secret Paladin than Druid here. And NoTomorrow, 3 ramp pieces in his hand already. It would be really nice if he had something to ramp into. Unfortunately, he doesn't. But we'll see how this works out for him.
Yeah, and 1, 2, 3, 4. They were already.
Wow, just going to coin into Aspirant. That's incredible early start to the... this is like the picture-perfect start to playing League of Legends. You get Darnassus, Aspirant, League Wild of... Growth, Innervate...
Hearthstone.
Hearthstone, yeah. Wrong eSport there. It's somewhat different. But
I was like, yeah, wait, you can curve out in League of Legends? That's
really cool. I mean, I guess I'm sure I could come up with some sort of analogy. But yeah, best way to play Hearthstone, you get tons of mana, all of it's free. You play whatever you want, whenever you want to. It's like those tavern brawls that like either discount your cards for free or just like start you off with 10 mana and you can only play one card per turn, stuff like that. It's like, hey, you can now play whatever you want and you have tons of mana and kill off early game threats, and nothing is too big a problem for you.
Right. Well, in this case, it's looking very bad for Zuiwo. This is the dream start for Druid against Secret Paladin. You could not ask for anything better. I mean, you could have a better hand, but as far as the first two turns, this is completely ideal. So what do you do here if you are Zuiwo? You could just go for the Coghammer. You attack with the mini-bot, ping up, get the shield off, and then you put the Coghammer on, the shield comes back. That's kind of weak to your opponent just using the hero power, but there's nothing too much better here. I guess another option is just play out the spider, and then play out Competitive Spirit. The only problem is, no matter what you do, your opponent can just ping off the shield with their hero power, so you kind of feel compelled to attack in. Wait, don't do that. Okay, he's kind of
you gotta
attack first. But I think you kind of have to attack here, as painful as it is against a druid. But
I mean, it kind of feels bad, but he's at 26 health, so like health is an expendable resource at this point, because he doesn't really have too much to worry about. And of course, he does know that he's going up against a druid. We already saw a little bit of ramp there from the Darnassus aspirin, so I think now is the time for all good men to come to the aid of the party and to play maybe a second wild growth, because I mean, I guess you either have to ping with your wrath or with your face after hero power.
All right, this is actually pretty awkward here for NoTomorrow. This is becoming my word awkward, right? But I mean, your hand is weird. You don't really, your hand isn't good at all. But you, so you kind of want the card, but the tempo of just hero powering and then wrathing this down is really nice as well. You keep both your minions on board, but looks like he is going to go for that wild growth like you mentioned. And I mean, despite that really good start from NoTomorrow, Zuiwo's still in this because NoTomorrow's hand isn't that great, and now, you know, Zuiwo gets to have a turn. He gets to clear his opponent's board. He's down to 18, which obviously is a concern, but he has the board. There's nothing for really NoTomorrow to do next turn unless he picks something up, and he'll be facing a Knife Juggler, a Haunted Creeper, and potentially Muster for Battle afterward.
I guess it kind of works both ways, because, you know, while it can be a nightmare to deal with a druid who has that good of an early start, you know, it's only good early. And later on, of course, it curves into stuff that is not quite as optimistic.
Right, so
to be fair, though, he's also going to get a perfect turn 6 drop, and so maybe he'll do the paladin thing and get a turn 7 immediately following that. But it's kind of interesting to see how that curve has worked out in NoTomorrow's favor.
Right. Address something in chat. People are confused. They don't think it's current because it's 2015. It says 2015 because it's the culmination of the entire gold series that occurred throughout 2015, starting, you know, early last year. So it basically goes on the entire time. The entire season is in 2015, and it culminates now in 2016. These are the grand finals. So it's kind of like the Super Bowl. If you think of, you know, the Super Bowl coming up would be the Super Bowl for the 2015 season. So this is happening right now, guys. This is live.
Yes, it certainly is. And I mean, I actually kind of wonder what the actual delay is from, like, when we say the words and see the things to when it actually happens all the way over in China. Because that's it's kind of crazy to think about how global everything is how significant it is that we are able to broadcast the pinnacle of Chinese Hearthstone esports here. But man, that swipe was looking super good before, and all of a sudden it's looking super not.
he can't, you know, predict that it's going to be competitive spirit, but he really got burned in that situation.
Right.
The one problem here for Zuiwo is he kind of has to throw these tutus into the Thorisin, because now if your opponent has combo, it's reduced down to 7, and that would be lethal for NoTomorrow. It depends on how much of a risk that Zuiwo wants to take. Obviously, a lot of times you want to play slightly safe against druid because it's a favored matchup, but it's with the start that NoTomorrow had, it's not so favored anymore. So it kind of depends on what you want to do here, or how risky you want to play here. We can see that NoTomorrow doesn't have combo in hand, and NoTomorrow would have lethal even through Noble Sacrifice. So he kind of has to start having to deal with this, unfortunately. But going to be the Noble Sacrifice come out, and now his board is weak to swipe. I guess one of the benefits of not playing swipe is your opponent thinks that that you don't have swipe when in fact you do. And there's a Harrison Jones. Unfortunately, can't play swipe and Harrison Jones at the same time. I think you still go for the Harrison, though, because you are taking a bit of damage, but there's no real burst in Paladin, and you do have BJs for the next turn, so everything concerned, looking at both hands, it's looking really good for NoTomorrow, honestly.
Well, for NoTomorrow, what are his options? He's got swipe. That's a great way to clear the board. You can't really do a whole lot other than just swipe, and then I guess hero power this turn. Another option would be to play Harrison Jones to get a ton of cards, but I feel like that's kind of underutilizing the power.
I like this. I like going with the hero power first, because if it's Avenge or something, you can use swipe to clear whatever gets buffed off. And ideally, it goes into 2-2 and everything is cleared. And if it's not, like you see here, maybe he can just go for Harrison Jones, and you're not really too worried about the board right now.
Yeah,
All right,
that's
well.
true. NoTomorrow should be fine if he doesn't play the tempo BGH. Oh.
This is kind of okay too. I guess he favors tempo. I mean, Sylvanas isn't always tempo, but it slows your opponent down quite a lot, because they either have to trade everything into it or really risk not trading into it by going phase there. So yeah, this Sylvanas basically healed him for five here, which is kind of nice.
Yeah, and NoTomorrow has a combo of the Savage Roar and the BGH that he actually could kill his Sylvanas in the future if he feels to, so
Right.
definitely makes sense.
Well, Zuiwo was deciding between the Mysterious Challenger and the Dr. Boom. Whatever you played, I believe that there was going to be a way to BGH what came out. The question here is, what do you do along with the BGH? Looks like it's going to be Harrison Jones. Nice, good old 5-mana Ancient of Lore. Feels pretty good. And yeah, just going to take that out. Doesn't really need to use a swipe on just Boom Bot, so it's perfectly fine. And now Zuiwo was really feeling the pain here.
Oh, Lothar is actually rather good, but the board is not working in his favor.
Ooh. Okay, well, he can
Ooh.
still clear the board. Doesn't clear the board, unfortunately. I mean, not the worst luck there. Obviously, he would have preferred to have gotten more. But if you. I mean, you're able to clear at least one out and get some damage onto the other one, potentially. If this is left alone, then maybe you can kill the Harrison pretty easily. But so that's those four secrets, I believe, are Repentance, Redemption, Avenge, and Noble Sacrifice. And so this makes it slightly difficult for NoTomorrow to deal with, but he does have Spell Power Swipe, which is very good. Looks like he's gonna lead off with just attacking in. And this allows him to use. He can use Swipe plus Savage Roar to guaranteed kill this Mysterious Challenger, even if it lands on that. So. Or maybe just swipe, I guess. Yeah, just swipe is fine. From there, you can't really do anything else, but at least your opponent's board is cleared, and you have a huge card advantage.
Yes, definitely true. But talking about carbon advantage is something that what they were could do is drawing into Divine Favor that we didn't actually saw as of now. So advantage, not what you want.
I mean, it could be reasonable here, especially because you've already seen Big Game Hunter. And I mean, right now, I mean, it seems like it's been going super well for NoTomorrow, but Zero is still in this. If you can maybe top deck a Taryon or something like that, this Repentance. I mean, NoTomorrow knows that the Repentance is going to go off here, and he probably assumed that that's going to be Avenge. I mean, based on the earlier game, I'm pretty sure there's no other Redemption. We could actually see a heal here. No, it looks like he's gonna go for cards instead. But yeah, it definitely makes sense to go for more options, particularly if you might see Tyrion coming up in the future. And again, Paladin doesn't really have any burst, so you're kind of fine just not healing there. But
Haunted Griever?
yeah, very very poor here. I think at this point you kind of had to start hitting the face and just not worry about combo. But if he does go face here, I believe that's going to be game. Double Savage Roar plus Swipe on top of that is going to be well more than enough, I believe here. And I mean, I'm not even doing the math. I'm just not even gonna bother. I'm pretty sure that's way more than enough. And yeah, NoTomorrow does see it. Just gonna send everything to the face. I don't even need the swipe. And that is going to be game over to NoTomorrow. Takes the unfavored matchup, and we are going to a game five. And depending on what the Warlock is for NoTomorrow, I mean, it all rides in that, right? If it's a good matchup, then it's good for him. If it's a bad matchup, it's not too bad or it's not good for him. But we'll see what happens here. The fact they went with Druid first makes me think that it might be Zulok, but we'll have to see.
Yeah, and actually, what's interesting is that Zuiwo's secret pattern is kind of old because you see other tech choices from him. That it's not as old that you play something like a Harvest Golem in there, but there might be the things he might take out like a Haunted Creeper, which kind of. And too slow. Just I'm really having trouble with Haunted Creeper in a lot of decks, except for like mid-range Hunter. So, yeah. But we'll see what kind of Warlock that NoTomorrow is bringing. He can be also thinking that, yeah, I'm playing real log, and I'm going to get a fair matchup if I can win this difficult matchup. So I'm going to be more confident in this game five as well.
Or maybe it's completely mind games, right? As we see, actually take a look at this deck. But I mean, if we think that it's a bad matchup, then maybe he can mind games Zuiwo into thinking that it's Zu when it's actually not. But it is going to be Zu, so we're gonna have another yet another unfavored matchup here for NoTomorrow. He's still up against it, still not out of this loser's match quite yet. We'll see who's able to take it. It all rides on this right here. And we'll see how these players play it out. Reasonable start here with the Voidwalker on turn one by NoTomorrow, but has no turn two at the moment. Could maybe use a Power of Roaming if he really feels it's necessary. But otherwise, it's might not go well for him coming up on turn two. But it looks like it is going to be a coin into something. And yeah, it could have either been Redemption or the Noble Sacrifice. Looks like it's going to be the Noble Sacrifice, and it's still almost guaranteed that Zuiwo can take out this Voidwalker next turn.
Talking about those turn two play.
Yeah, Dark Pillar is pretty good, and the nice thing about Dark Pillar is that it allows you to have a turn three player as well, so that's kind of nice. Obviously, the downside, the fact that it's just a 2/2. But he has a choice here. It was going to be either between the Void Walker and what was the other card? The Power of Whelming. Already had the Power of Whelming in hand, so it makes sense for him to go for this. He's not. I mean, this is an attrition game, right? He doesn't want really the extra damage, so definitely makes sense in this regard. So you're going to play out his Knife Juggler, realizing that this Dark Pillar is going to get a good trade regardless. So he's going to just gives the opponent the choice here. NoTomorrow chooses to take out the Knife Juggler, which definitely makes sense because even if there's another secret coming out, it's still vulnerable. Speaking of the Secret Keeper, it's still vulnerable to the Flame Imp. And now, so here's where the Redemption actually comes in kind of handy. It could resurrect this Haunted Creeper. It does have a decent, chance of getting back this Pallid Treader. But the Secret Keeper won't be the greatest here. Implosion rolls for three, which is fair and balanced. I always like to see fair and balanced implosions here.
Like Fox News.
Exactly. Fox News, the most fair and balanced of newscasts. Nice starter placement right in the middle there. I like to see that from Zuiwo. And Repentance is a very poor card for him to get, and I mean, this is kind of not looking the greatest for Zuiwo. At this point, you kind of have you hope that you already have the tempo lead at this point, and it's definitely not the case.
Yeah, NoTomorrow actually could get sort of broke here with the power overwhelming.
Pre no, well.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's kind of wasteful to use that shredder.
Yeah, well, you could clear everything but the 2-drop, and if you clear the 2-drop, then even if it's a 1 health, then you can't kill the 2/1s remaining. So not exactly a board clear, but see where you're coming from. In the case of Zuiwo here, he can play the Repentance, but it's pretty poor against Zu, because whatever Zu plays out there, I mean, Zu usually has at least something to play out to basically counter that. It does kind of force your opponent to use mana, but if it is something like an Abusive Sergeant, you're not really getting too much out of it. We do see that there's the Dire Elf Alpha in the hand of NoTomorrow, so would be able to take that out or to proc that Seeker pretty easily. And yeah, so things again looking, it's just going really back and forth. Actually going to be the muster for battle here, just kind of get as many 1/1s on the board. This definitely makes sense. I mean, Zu notoriously has a hard time dealing with a bunch of 1/1s in the field. No AoE in the deck, other than like Knife Juggler with Implosion. All right, Doomguard hits the field. I imagine, I mean, we're probably gonna see a tap here, right? I don't see anything else. 9.5% chance it says for any Mysterious Challenger to come out. And we actually could see a Power of Whelming here, potentially. Just because, I mean, you kind of need to finish the game out at some point. But yeah, it looks like it's just going to be a tap. Going to kill off this Youthful Brewmaster. And follow that up with what? Probably just a Flame Imp. I mean, you this Dire just kind of dies. It is more mana efficient, but it's more useful later.
Yeah, and you're pretty much down if your opponent has Consecration anyways, so...
We haven't seen really Consecrate from... I think we saw Consecrate one time, so I'm pretty sure it's only one of in the deck, so not too worried about that, especially because your opponent only has three cards. So let's see, can he hit that 9.5 chance? Nope, doesn't get that. He does have a Knife Juggler, however, which is reasonable. He can just play on the field, play his Shredder, start clearing out some stuff, see what hits here. I imagine he might clear everything but the Doomguard.
Yeah. I think that is the case here.
So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and do that. And, I mean, this is kind of the problem, right, with playing... Or the reason why the Zoo isn't great against Secret Paladin, because you kind of trade back and forth, and, you know, in the end, Zoo was just... I mean, he's at 16 health. How did that happen? I don't even know. This game has just been back and forth. I know, but this game has been back and forth the entire time, and all of a sudden, you know, he's just at no health. But looks like it's going to be an all-in play here from NoTomorrow. Just going to attack the face and get a massive... Void Terror. He's gonna take away some of the damage from that Void or from that Direwolf Alpha, but gonna be big enough to, I think, one shot his opponent. Let's see, 14-13, so not quite, but he does have the Doomguard in hand, so. Oh, that is a huge top deck from Zuiwo here. Gets the Coghammer. That's what he needed. He needed some sort of taunt to get in the way. And look at NoTomorrow. He is devastated here. And I imagine you just play everything out here if you are. So you play out the Repentance as well. That Doomguard will turn into a 5-1 if it's played first. And this is absolutely heartbreaking if you're NoTomorrow.
And I was hoping that his opponent doesn't get a now.
That's going to be it, right? I mean, there has to be a taunt here. There has to be a Defender of Argus right now. Nope, doesn't pick it up.
I mean, it could be an owl. Owl would be lethal.
Owl would be lethal, but...
That's not a...
Not going to be it. No, tomorrow is going to be your first player eliminated from Group C. Zuiwo survives to move on to the decider match. We'll see if he is able to move on against the loser of Pegy and LiBo. But the bigger story here is that No Tomorrow is out, your BlizzCon qualifier. Looks like he's still in okay spirits despite, you know, losing yesterday and today. But yeah, the number one seed in this group, the player that we expected to move on, will be out first here. Unfortunate for him.